In this video, we are going to discuss about Lex and Yacc programs for the grammar. S produces L equal to R, R, R. L produces star R or ID. R produces L. So this is part of Compiler Design Lab. So first, let us see the problem solution. Write Yacc program and Lex program for the following grammar. Then you need to form the valid and invalid input strings manually and give them as input for the executable code of Yacc and Lex programs and validate the input strings. So the given grammar is S produces L equal to R or R, L produces star R or ID, R produces L. So now let us see what is the solution. So the first, let us see the Lex program. So here in the user definition part of the Lex program, we are going to include the required header file. So first we have included standard input output header file. Then y.tab.h is included. So in this header file, all the tokens which are defined in the Yacc program and their unique token ID will be there in this header file. Then yyl value that will be used to pass the value between the Lex and Yacc program. So now let us see the rule part of the Lex program. So here, if there are any identifiers recognized, so beginning with the alphabet followed by alphabet or digits for any number of time, if it is there, we are going to return the ID token. And if there are any tab, we are not going to return anything. And if there are any single character, we are going to return yy text of 0. That is the first character whatever we recognize in the lexeme that we are going to return. If it is new line character or space, just return 0. So now, if there are anything, if we want to keep back to the input buffer of the lexer, then this yy wrap function will be helpful. So now let us see the Yacc program. So in the Yacc program, include the header file as necessary. So here we have included standard input output header file. So that using that we can use scanf printf statement in our Yacc program. So here the flag is initialized to 0. So now the token which is going to be communicated from the Lex to Yacc tool is identifier. So percentage token ID will be useful for that. Then in the rule part, we are going to write the grammar. So here the grammar consists of three production rules. So there is three non-terminals, S, R and L. And there is one term. There are three terminals, equal, star and ID. ID is a token which will be communicating from Lex to the Yacc tool. And equal will be transferred. If there are if yy text of 0 we have written from the Lex tool to the Yacc tool. So that will be, if it is equal, it will come here. If it is star, it will be passed here. So S produces S equal to L R R. So if the input is reduced to the start symbol S, then the flag will be incremented by 1. Then L produces star R or ID. So if there are any identifier recognized in the input, it will be mapped to this ID token and then it will be reduced to L. Then R produces L. So if L identifier is there, it will be reduced to L and L will be reduced to R and R can be reduced to S. And in your input, if you are using star or equal along with the identifier also, it will be recognized. So with respect to this grammar, whatever the input symbols, input string you want to form, you can form and you can try it. So then finally, semicolon we have to use for terminating our grammar. So in the main subroutine part, we are going to prompt the user to input valid or invalid input with respect to this grammar. Then call yyparse function. So when we call that in the YAAK program, whatever the grammar we have written for that, respective subroutines will be generated, and that will be, they'll be called here. Then if the flag is true, then it is valid expression. That is, if your input is reduced to the start symbol, then the flag will be incremented. Such case, valid expression. Else, we are calling YY error function. So, in the YY error function, we are just printing that it is syntax error. So, this very simple program, you can try it out. Thank you.